None too soon from the looks of them. See here, Caleb.
Look for the woman. Literally sent from heaven. This man is a minister. Joseph. Reverend, we'll take care of you.
Should be all right, Mr. Hobbs.
Oh, I think so. Bethia will look after, won't you, Bethia?
Of course, Mr. Hobbs.
I have no idea how long we were out there. We lost track of time. It seemed as though we kept going. We never got anywhere.
Well, the desert's all the same.
The mountains appeared never to get closer.
And you must have made a wrong turn somewhere. Got lost. It's happened to others.
Mr. Hobbs, I seem to remember there was a...
My daughter Deliverance.
Yes, I remember. Well, thank you for your help.
Excuse my daughter, Mr. Keyes. She has an affliction. She can't talk. She can hear and understand everything that's said to her, but she's unable to speak. Thank you, my dear. I sent Joseph and some of the men out. They've just brought your wagon back.
Oh, I'd like to go out and thank them.
Well, maybe you're still a little too tired. Why don't you wait a while?
I'm all right. I'd like to.
All right.
Like the book says, gather up the fragments that remain, that none be lost.
Joseph, if you haven't gathered up my wife and me and brought us here to,
San Malis.
San Malis. We've been through many a western town, but I've never quite seen anything like this.
Well, you see, Reverend, we are from New England. Connecticut. Some of our buildings here, our mode of dress, even our speech. It's hard to break old time.
Hello, Mr. Hobbs.
Hello, Eden. How are you?
Fine. How are you today, sir?
Fine, thank you.
Hi, Joseph.
Well, Dad was injured in a runaway wagon. I'm afraid he'll never be able to walk again without those crutches. One of a series of misfortunes has struck our village lately.
Misfortune?
Well, I don't want to trouble you with our problems.
I'd like you to tell me.
Well, we worked a mine here. Gold. Not the richest mine in the world, but enough to sustain the village. And it played out. Doesn't pay now to even work it.
Tell the Reverend about the church, Caleb.
Some time ago, our church burned down. And shortly after, our minister took ill and died.
Like the book says, Reverend, we have suffered many things in vain.
Let's look on the brighter side, Joseph. Now, when we found you in the desert, the minister, we had hope that you might stay with us and
Caleb!
Help us.
Caleb, he's coming.
Moon's coming.
I'll go to him.
What do you think he'll do?
I don't know. Just remain calm and tell the others to do the same.
Mm-hmm.
may be the worst of our misfortunes. Shutting down the mine. The last of your share, sorry.
I'll be back.
We've nothing more to give you.
I'll be back.
Please, leave us alone.
Moon, wickedness proceedeth from the wicked. But our hand shall not be upon thee.
Moon, he's an old man. He meant no harm, just an old man.
Let him go. Let go and you'll kill him. Stop it. Turn him loose. Let him go.
Thank you, Reverend. Thank
Let him
you.
Loose, you'll kill him.
Thank you, Reverend. Thank you kindly, Reverend.
Reverend? So we got a preacher man among us.
Let him go. Turn him loose.
I'll let him loose when I'm ready. I'll be back, preacher man.
All right, Joseph.
I'll make it, Reverend. Thanks be to you.
John, I'm sorry to get you involved in this.
That's hard to believe. It's hard to believe that one man, one lone man, can exact tribute from a whole town.
You saw the way he handles those guns. You know the kind of man he is.
If it wasn't for you, Reverend, I might not be among the living.
Well, where's the law? Don't you have a sheriff?
Only a mayor. Me.
All right. Moon has two guns. Don't the people of San Malis have guns?
We don't believe in violence.
He who lives by the sword dies by the sword.
I know, Joseph. But do you believe in paying tribute to evil?
You're right, Reverend. Moon is evil. But so long as we had the gold to give, it seemed the easier path.
Well, now that you no longer have the gold, what are you going to do?
I don't know.
Can't you send for a marshal?
We're such a small community, so far off the beaten path.
But Moon said he'd be back.
Yeah, I know. Reverend, what were your plans? Where were you and your wife? What was your destination?
Seguera. Minister there is retiring in the year, and I'm going to assist him until then.
Thank you.
Well, you'll be staying a while, at least until Mrs. Keyes is able to travel. Now, I was just wondering. You said a while back you might be able to help. I think you can.
How?
As you know, the people of San Melis have been very depressed lately. I think it would be a great comfort to them if you could conduct the services this Sunday.
A great comfort, Reverend.
Of course, you have no church to offer you, but I'm sure we can find some suitable spot.
I would consider it an honor.
Excuse me, sir. It's your wife. She's asking for you.
Thank you.
You sent me a fine young man.
Wagon. The sun. Oh, Jonathan, that sun still burns
no,
in my brain.
No, you don't even have to think about that. All you have to think about is getting better. Soon, very soon.
Were we in Seguro?
No, but
with friends. A place called San Milas.
What happened?
It's nothing. I'm all right.
How did you get us here?
I didn't. Some people found us.
In the middle of the desert?
Mm-hmm. We were very lucky. Now you have to get some rest.
Jonathan?
What?
I never lost faith in you. Morning, Deliverance.
Morning, Jacob. Joseph.
Morning.
Morning. Mr. Hobbs thought you might have need for some of the things in here.
Oh, it was very thoughtful. Now, you can put it anywhere.
What a beautiful candle. It almost seems a shame to burn it.
Deliverance makes those candles herself.
She does?
Yes, ma'am. Out in the shed.
I'd like to watch you sometime.
I was just working on the sermon for tomorrow. You're going to be there, aren't you, Deliver?
Is there anything else we can get you, ma'am?
No, thank you, Joseph. We won't be in San Melis that long.
Thank you.
And taught them, saying, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they that hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they that are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you and say all manner of evil against you for my sake. Falsely, for my sake, rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. Ask, and ye shall receive. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For every one that asketh, receiveth, and he that seeketh, findeth. My friends, you have done me a great honor asking me to come to speak to you this day. I know this is not the best of times for you. You have been visited by misfortunes as hard as a piece of the nether millstone. There is darkness at noon, but you must not lose hope. You must not give up. You're not forgotten. You are not lost. I know. Just a short while ago, it seemed that my wife and I were lost. hopeless, abandoned, our bodies too weak to move, our spirits shattered. But there is a strength within. If only you will summon up that strength, for there is hope in the midst of despair. There is a candle in the darkness. There is. Drink on the barren desert. There is balm in bitterness. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions and walk with faith. Faith. Draw upon that spirit within. Lift up your eyes unto the hills. Arise and renew your strength. And you shall mount up with wings as eagles. Hearken unto the voice of my cry. Behold, rejoice. You shall walk and not be weary.
Shall be lifted, and your crooked shall be straight.
Well, thank you all for coming by, but it is getting kind of late, and it's been a trying day for Mr. Keyes. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
You'll see you all again tomorrow.
It's a miracle, Reverend. Like the book says, you gave feet to the lame.
No, not really. I didn't do anything.
You're too modest, John. You've given us hope. This may be the beginning of better times for us. I'll tell you something else. The whole town wishes you were staying.
Well, thank you, but that's impossible.
Nothing's impossible, not after today.
I think I'd better look in on Lorna. She's not feeling well again.
Yeah, too much excitement. Should have stayed in bed a few more days.
You're probably right. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, John.
Good night.
Oh, I haven't seen Deliverance this evening.
Oh, she's probably working in the shed.
Please say goodnight for me.
Deliverance?
I don't mean to disturb you. I just wanted to say goodnight.
Well, thank you.
No, I haven't seen candles made since I was a little boy. I can't. This is more like sculpture, isn't it?
Something.
That's beautiful. Well, as I said, I just wanted to come in and say goodnight to you. I'm glad he was healed. No, I didn't do anything. He healed himself. No. You want to know if I can help you? Deliverance, I wish I could. I only wish I could.
Could you ever speak? And this happened when you were very, very little, huh?
I'll find out more from Caleb. Well, as I said, I just wanted to say goodnight.
You, don't work too late.
Waiting up for you.
Well, I went outside for a while to get some fresh air. It's a beautiful night. How are you feeling now?
A little tired and weak. And there's that throbbing inside my head again.
I think Mr. Hobbs was right.
About what?
Said you got out of bed too soon.
And you know I wouldn't miss your sermon. Jonathan.
Hmm?
That boy.
Ethan.
Well, what do you think happened?
I don't know.
I think that it was your strength that went out to him when you spoke. The voice of my beloved. Behold, he cometh, leaping upon the mountains, skipping upon the hills. You remember Jonathan, don't you?
I remember.
The Song of Solomon, our song. Oh, Jonathan, we're going to be very happy in Saguaro.
Yes.
I would like to go there as soon as possible.
All right. Now, why don't you just close your eyes and get a little rest, huh?
Like a nightmare, and you're wringing wet.
Yeah, I just laid down for a while and I fell asleep.
anything I can do?
No, you already have.
Mom, come on back to bed, and I'll sit up with you until you go to sleep. Jonathan.
She must have been walking in her sleep, Reverend.
No. No, I wasn't asleep. I saw them.
No.
Jonathan, I was awake. I was awake and I saw them.
It's probably my fault. I had that dream
No.
that you went back to sleep.
No, I tell you, I saw them.
Lorna.
Look, right here. Right here. There were four of them. They were wearing robes and they had candles and... They had masks on their faces. They were like animals. There was a goat and an owl.
You feel the effects of the sun. It's playing tricks on your mind.
No. No, I saw them, Jonathan. I saw them. Right here. Right on this stump. It was a dead owl.
It's been a trying day for all of us.
Don't you look at me like that! Jonathan, I saw them, I swear to you. Deliverance was here. Deliverance. Deliverance, please tell them, please. Jonathan, believe me!
I believe...
Jonathan!
It look better in the morning.
Jonathan, I swear to you. I swear to you, I
we'll
saw them.
We'll go inside
please
and we'll get some rest.
Me.
It's all right.
Believe me, don't you? Jonathan?
Hmm?
I said that you do believe that I did see something out there last night.
Yes, I do.
Thank you, Jonathan. It's very important to me that you believe me.
You're very important to me. Most important thing in the whole world.
We're not going to stay here much longer, are we?
No.
There is something about this town and these people. Don't you feel it?
No, I don't. Caleb's the warmest, most generous...
Not Caleb.
Then who?
Never mind.
Come in.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, ma'am. I brought you your breakfast, ma'am. Oh, the others have eaten, sir, but I'd be happy to fix you some breakfast. Thank right you. Away.
I'm not hungry.
Yes, sir.
Jonathan, would you please bring me some paper and your pen from the desk?
What?
I want to write Reverend Mason a letter. No! Just to tell him that we're going to be delayed.
That's a good idea, then.
Well, I'll fetch him for you, ma'am.
Thank you, Bethia.
Yes, sir.
I'm going out, dear.
Feeling better this morning, ma'am?
I'm just fine.
Well, now, come along. Eat your breakfast, ma'am. It'll give you strength.
Morning, John.
Morning.
You don't believe she was sleepwalking?
Well, if she was, there was somebody else out here, too.
What do you mean?
It's candle wax, yeah.
Oh, you'll find that all over the yard. Deliverance's shed is just over there. She often gives wax to the children to play with.
Maybe they were playing right here last night.
John, I'm very fond of Lorna. She's a fine girl. But I honestly think she's still affected by that terrible ordeal in the desert.
Yeah, maybe I am, too. Caleb, this affliction of deliverances, how did she get it?
Well, as a child, she had a lot of bad dreams. Nightmares, I suppose you'd call them. We'd ask her what they were about, she'd never tell us. And one night, she woke up screaming. That was the last sound she uttered.
I see.
You think you can help her, John?
I don't know.
I hope so. I'd be... Well, she's everything I have.
I understand.
Get out!
Come on, Dick.
Hill! Wait till you see what we found. Just wait till you see what we brought with us.
Caleb, it's a miracle.
What's the matter? What happened, Joseph?
We was out at the mine, boarding it up like you said, so the children wouldn't go in there and get lost. And it happened.
What happened?
One of the old shafts collapsed. And Caleb, there it was. The richest vein I ever seen. Just look.
Oh! Oh!
More like this?
A whole mountain more. Yes, sir, Reverend. You brought us good fortune.
John, the first thing we're going to do is build a new church.
Yeah!
I don't know, ma'am. I'll find out.
Would you do me a favor, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Would you see that that gets out in the next mail?
Of course, ma'am.
thinking about.
They're going to start building the church tomorrow.
They've asked you to stay, haven't they?
Yes.
Do you want to stay?
Well, we have promised Reverend Mason.
Do you want to stay, Jonathan?
They're fine people. Lorna, they saved our lives. Caleb has opened his home to us, taking care of you. He's treated me like a son.
I know.
What is it?
I told you before, Jonathan. It's as if they were from another time, another world.
Caleb explained that. Now, when the settlers come from the old country, they bring their customs and their languages with them. These people are from New England.
I suppose.
And, Lorna, I've been able to help them. They're really fond of me. Of us, they need us. And Caleb said he'd build us a house and pay us more than we could ever hope for in Saguaro.
Jonathan, we weren't going to Saguaro for the money.
I know. I'm sorry.
It's just that I've sent Reverend Mason a letter telling him that we're on our way. But are we, Jonathan?
You don't want to stay here, do you?
Whither thou goest, I will go. And where thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people.
Thy people shall be my people.
Thy people shall be my people.
Saguaro, just as soon as you have enough strength.
Well, Jonathan, I feel better already.
Well, it'll be a week, 2 weeks. We still have a lot of desert to cross.
Thinking about all that desert makes me thirsty.
You want some water?
You know, Jonathan, I think I would.
Well, then, my darling bride, your husband's going to get you some water.
Bad luck.
Decided to come out today. Fresh air will do you good.
Boone, we've had a stroke of good fortune. We found a new vein in the mine, and it's a rich one. We'll have more gold than we ever had before. And you'll get your share.
Boone, you'll be rich. Come back in a few weeks.
I'll be back for the gold. I'm taking something else this time.
Moon!
Oh, it's the preacher man.
Moon, in the name of decency.
Never heard of it. Now, you listen to me. The first time, you got away easy. Don't push it.
No, I won't let you take it!
Anybody else want to stop me? Well, go ahead. Come on, try it. There it is. Pick it up.
Come on, try it.
And don't follow us, because you won't want to see her.
He wasn't a man.
I've killed.
But you saved her. You saved us all. He was an animal. A mad dog.
Not getting any better. I'm worried. I wish there were a doctor here.
Well, the best medicine in the world for her now is you.
I wish she hadn't been there today to see what happened.
I know.
Look.
Would you like some tea, Reverend?
Never mind the tea, Joseph. What he needs, what we all need, is a jigger of brandy. A double jigger. Never forget what you've done for us. For all of us. Won't you reconsider? Make San Milas your home. Will you, John?
I'm afraid that's impossible. I think it's best that we leave all this behind.
Well, at least wait until the church is built. You've got to do that. Preach the first sermon. The first sermon, John. Will you do that?
Please.
Your 2 weeks and more.
My 2 weeks?
Don't you think I know what's going on here?
Honey, what are you talking about?
Never mind. We're leaving. We're getting out of here. Do you hear me?
Listen to yourself, honey. You sound like...
You don't like the way I sound, do you, or the way I look? You'd rather look at someone else, wouldn't you?
Mona, please.
Wouldn't you? We're leaving here tomorrow.
Just wait until Sunday.
No! Those people!
They have been awfully busy. The church is almost finished, and I promise...
Them! That's all you care about? Well, I've had enough of them and this place.
Lorna, you're not well enough to travel.
I will never get well here! Never!
Lorna...
If you're such a miracle worker like they think you are, like you think you are, then heal me, miracle man.
I want to help
you. Heal me.
I want to help you.
Do you? Or do you want me to die? Yes.
Oh, no.
Then you could stay, couldn't you? Couldn't you, Miracle Man?
I love you.
Do you?
I love you.
We're leaving here tomorrow. Tomorrow!
Reverend.
Yes, Ethan.
They say you're going away. I wish you wasn't. My legs are getting stronger every day. I bet I'll be able to run pretty soon.
That's good, Ethan.
I just wanted to thank you.
Father says you're leaving tomorrow.
Yes.
Do you want to go? Jonathan?
Lorna wants to leave tomorrow.
Lorna is sick.
I know that, but she doesn't want to stay here anymore.
Do you? Well, we hope you will, at least till Sunday. Maybe Lorna will change her mind.
I don't think so.
Jonathan, I've been reading. May I read to you? I am my beloved's, and his desire is toward me. Come, my beloved. Let us go forth into the fields. Let us lodge in the villages. Let us get up early to the vineyards. Let us see if the vines flourish. Whether together, the tender grapes appear, and the pomegranates bud forth. There will I give thee my loves.
That was very good, Deliverance.
Would you like me to read more? It's from the Song of Solomon.
Yes, I know. I'd better get back to Lorna.
Glad you're getting down, John. I was hoping to have a little talk.
Caleb, I'd like a drink of that brandy, if you don't mind.
We'll all have one.
Use a little wine for thy stomach's sake and for thine infirmities.
It's just too bad it has to be a farewell drink.
Yes, it is.
Why does it have to be? Can't you persuade Lorna?
Caleb, my wife is very ill. There's just no reasoning with her. I'm afraid if we don't leave tomorrow, she'll break down completely.
I understand, boy. It's just you could do so much good here.
Somebody else I have to do.
Well, in that case, we'll help you all we can. Your wagon is repaired. Most of your stuff is loaded. You'll have the best horses in town and a map to guide you through the desert.
There's something else that's been bothering me. I haven't asked you.
What is it?
Did you bury Moon?
Yes.
A minister should have said a few words over him.
Well, we thought, John, it'd be best for you if you forgot it. Now, when we do get a new minister, we'll have him do that.
Thank you, Caleb, for everything.
No, we are in your debt, more than I can tell you. Now, would you like Joseph and some of the men to ride with you part way through the desert?
No, I think it's best we leave alone.
What do you think, Caleb?
Joseph, as I said before, I think he's a fine young man.
Ha ha ha!
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow,
Don, your wagon is outside. Laura?
I don't know.
Well, Jonathan, I'm afraid you'll be staying a while longer. Citizens of San Milas, we have come here today to dedicate this new edifice and at the same time to show our appreciation to a man who's just recently come among us, a man for whom we've waited a long time, a man who's made this day possible. Although his wife is ill and is unable to be with us, he has agreed to say the first sermon to be heard inside these walls. And regretfully, the last sermon we shall hear from him. I give you the finest, the bravest, the most decent man who's ever come to us, the Reverend John Keyes.
I am a stranger and a sojourner among you. And who among us can look into another's heart and know what is there? As I stand here and I look into your faces, faces of trust, friendship, of belief, I must reveal what is in my heart. For you and for myself, because the heart can be deceitful. My first sermon to you was to be the Ten Commandments, those laws that were handed down to each of us to live by.
But now as I think back on what has happened and what I have done, I cannot find it in my heart to speak of them, those laws that were handed down to each of us to live by. I have allowed myself to become the subject of your idolatry. I have deceived. I have lied. I have coveted that which is not mine. I have killed. I have become corrupted. Sorry, please come back to me. Please.
Is it? What's happening?
It's an eclipse, Reverend. That's what we've been waiting for.
We didn't just happen to find you. We changed the road sign. And now it's nearly time for our ceremony.
No. No. You're dead. I killed you. I saw your grave.
The grave was empty. It was a sham. A game to keep you here.
But why?
We have a covenant with death, and with hell, are we at agreement?
Some people call it a Sabbath. In our ceremony, we have need for a man like yourself. A man who, in the eyes of your world, is pure and uncorrupted. Ah, but were you, Reverend Keats? No, in you is the seed of corruption. We merely tended it and nourished it until you fell from grace.
Last time it was him.
He tried to warn me.
We are not from Connecticut. We're from a village in Massachusetts. Long time ago.
Deliverance.
My name is Nineveh. The witch that Adam loved. Before the gift of Eve.
Thank you. Try it again, honey.
Give me a hand.